Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever time of day this may be for you. My name is Nico, and this is our Brown Farmhouse, aka the Brown Family Farm. We hope everyone's having an amazing day. Thank you for clicking on this video and deciding that you want to spend 20, 30, 40, however long this video is, minutes with us. We truly appreciate and love each and every single one of you. It's 4th of July, y'all. Woo! We have family in town. Of course, I'm surrounded by my lovely family, Natalie, our oldest daughter, Egypt, our youngest daughter, Sahara, and our newborn baby boy, Pharaoh. A lot of you have been asking some questions, not only about our family, but about how did we come up with the names for our kids, names for our animals, things like that. Remember, once we get to 10,000 subscribers, that's when Natalie and I plan to start going live, okay? That's our goal. And I have a secret for y'all. Come a little closer. I can't say this too loud in case Natalie's around, but look, y'all. Natalie and I are petrified of going live. We don't know why. We don't know if it's the realness of in the moment. You can't edit that, right? Do y'all actually want to hear from us? Do people care enough to want to come spend an hour with us live? This is all new for us, y'all, so we're just petrified, and we have so many questions, concerns, and fears. That was just some of them, but that's between us, right? I'm being vulnerable, just sharing the fears of Natalie and I, so bear with us. Whew. But y'all, we have so much going on. So much going on. And we have a lot of updates that are gonna be in this video for you. You're just gonna get to spend some time with the Browns and our family for 4th of July. All right, y'all, let's get to it.
She does have some basically necrosis wounds from how tight the bandage was on her neck, unfortunately. So it basically stopped the blood flow to that, which kills the skin and some of the underlying tissue. It does feel like she has a break in the leg just past the knee. So there are some wounds now which complicate things a bit. In order to treat it, the best treatment option would be to take x-rays, sedate her, take x-rays, cast it. Honestly, I'd probably just do a bandage. I'd probably take x-rays, bandage it today, and then we'd probably come back and cast it, only because of the wounds. I'm in a strong debate about it. Yeah. Then the other thing, the biggest complication is the fact of the wounds. So being you have a break, that bone's exposed. So the blood, bones are alive. Yeah. And so, you know, that's sometimes a harder concept to think about. You don't think about your bones really being alive. But so when you break them, you expose all the bone marrow and the blood vessels and everything to what's around it. If a livestock animal goes and breaks a bone, and breaks the skin where the bone breaks, there's nothing we can do about it. It's only when they break the bone and it stays in the skin that we can actually do something about it. Because once they break and the bone's exposed, then the bone is contaminated.
Yeah.
All right, y'all. It's the middle of the day, and we normally don't keep Tucker's food out, but he jumped up there like he wants to eat now, so going to go ahead and come in here and give Tucker some food. We've been trying not to keep the food just full in here because the flies are that bad, y'all. And if the food is just sitting, there will be flies everywhere. But I guess Tucker just wanted his dinner a little early, so Tucker's taken care of. And this is about 10 minutes after the vet left, and we're about to go ahead and give Caramel her CD&T. Since she's already separated, we're just gonna go ahead and do it. That's what the vet recommended. The rest of the girls get their CD&T in 2 weeks, and that's also when we'll go ahead and warm any that need it. But as y'all know, in our previous video, no, two videos ago, we did a health check on our goats, which included checking their FAMACHA. But mom, the doctor gave you some medicine. One a pill, one... Yeah, so walk us through what her directions were for that.
The pill, once a day, we can mix it with water and then shoot it down her mouth. And then a penicillin is 1.5 and at 4 o'clock.
1.5 mils? CCs? Yeah. CCs, which is the same thing
it's
as a mil.
Same thing, babe.
Yeah, yeah. So
1.5.
1.5, yeah.
Right here.
penicillin and every day at 4 o'clock.
Yeah, every day. She said it's best to do it at the same time. So they gave her it's a day at 4 p.m. Mm-hmm. So she said try to keep it, which I'm home.
Yeah.
So I could do that.
So the pill that we can either give her orally or let dissolve in water and shoot, do you remember what it was called?
No.
Me neither. That's why we let the professionals come out here. So we're gonna put that on the screen for you right now. But
it's on the bag.
Yeah, Mama and I are about to go ahead and give her CD&T. She's still coming down. They gave her I think she said it was an IV. An IV is what they gave to like sedate or calm her down so they could work on her. But they did an amazing job on that.
And come back in 2 days.
Okay, so yeah. What are we doing, Mama? What's going on?
By the time they watch this, it'll be Wednesday, right?
By the time that, yep.
Mm-hmm. So today, when you're watching this, they're going to come back, check on her, and then we'll look at the wound and go from there. Got some decisions to make. And with Esther, we're going to catch her and take care of her umbilical hernia that day.
And, of course, you could be watching this a week later, a month later, a year later. So when we say today, as you're watching this video, the vets are coming to look at her. That's July 5th, 2023. But I'm going to go ahead and hold her while Mama gives her the shot. Alrighty, y'all. So Mom is preparing the shot. You already have it in there?
And it's 2. Let me put this down.
Okay.
You can hold this.
So we have 2 cc's.
I don't have pockets.
So we've done this a million times, but Mama and I, once again, are going to be doing this to the rest of the goats in 2 weeks. And in that video, we'll explain how to do this, but
wait, girl, I gotta massage it.
Mama gave her the shot, now she's massaging it in, and hopefully by our next upload we could give you a more in-depth update on what direction we're heading with Caramel.
Yeah, and we are gonna put her mom and sister in here with her.
Yep. So as far as Esther, the pig, goes, the vet did come take a look at her today as well. And although Esther and Leroy are significantly more tame than they were when we brought them home, like at first, if you even thought about stepping into their area, they were running around everywhere, just crazy, going crazy. Now you can step in there and they just keep laying. They don't go crazy. You can kind of get close to them, but they're not tame enough to the point where we can control them, which one day we hope to have them. We're working on that. Y'all know we, outside of spending time with them, give them treats and things like that. Mom loves to give them apples. So because they're not there yet, when she comes out on Wednesday, she's going to go ahead and bring all the tools that she needs in order to safely look at her so that we can with confidence diagnose.
Well, and that way, once they have her caught, she was saying, if that's what needs to be done, then they can just knock it out versus catching her and then being like, oh, we don't have the stuff today. And then having to come back and do it again.
Yeah.
Cause pigs are smart.
Yeah.
So Esther's gonna be like, nah, you ain't gonna catch me again.
Get trying.
But yeah, so just to knock it out once versus putting her through that. There's no need to put the type of stress if you don't have to.
Yep, that's it, y'all. Y'all, I swear you see the darnest things. Tucker was just laid out on the edge of the pool. He heard me talking, so he lifted his head up. But he was just laid
out, stretched out, head down, the whole 9 yards. You look very comfortable, Tucker. I hope you enjoy. And I'm sorry to bother you. That was rude of me. Go ahead and get back to it, man.
Y'all, look at my little sister over there. She just got here this morning, so she's here for the 4th with us. I'm pretty sure at some point in this video, y'all will see kind of what we're doing to celebrate. But you know, I have my stepdad here. I have my stepbrother here. That's my sister. Y'all already saw Jaredith in the previous video. He's out here weed eating again, so y'all already know he's out here dancing. He had his headphones on. He's taking a little break. He's about to get back to it. But, you know, look, let me tell y'all something. She gonna get mad if she ever see this video. My sister is a city girl, y'all. She's helping me clean these waters out for the goslings who are over here. Just gave them some fresh food, some fresh water in that one, so the water's not hot, because that one's in the sun. Now, just so y'all know, the water my sister's cleaning out is in the house, in the shade. So it stays at a nice temperature. Then we have that one we refill for them. Then we have that little pool, which is really a feeder that's in there for them. Now, remember, they're going to graduate pretty soon here from that thing to that bigger pool. And Frankie, Natalie's actually at the store now. Frankie's graduating from that pool to a far larger pool. So they're getting hemi-downs. The goslings are about to get a hemi-down probably in the next week or so. But last night we had such an amazing time. This is July 4th, filming on Tuesday. So you're gonna be watching this on July 5th. And some of you have actually mentioned in the comments, you know, sometimes, you know, we don't have to film everything, just enjoy our family while they're here. And, you know, of course, in the back of our mind, we know that, but this is why we love y'all so much. You know, it's like confirmation in the comments by those of you that take time out of your busy days and weeks to spend time with our family. The confirmation that was in the comments of like, hey, just enjoy your family while they're there. You don't have to record everything. Truly, truly appreciate that. And we did that last night. So last night we had some great music going on the speaker. You know, old school. If you hear the music in my videos, and you know, my stepdad that's here, he's the one that raised me. Old school Motown, 40s, 50s, 60s. Then you get into some of the 80s kind of music, then early 90s music. That's what I like to listen to, and it's because of him. So we had great music going. We had a fire pit going over there under the shop right there. And we did s'mores, we had hot dogs, we had sausages, we had great drinks flowing. It was just an amazing time, y'all. But, you know, once again, we have some festivities for today that we're gonna be doing. And look, she finished the first one. So let me put this in the house for the goslings. All right, so here's the dish that I was talking about that is their current pool. So just gonna put that right there. And my sister is giving me the first of two buckets. I'm gonna pour this water in there. Let's see. I have one hand, y'all, because the other hand, of course, is holding the phone. Let's see if I can pull this off. Okay, probably only about half a bucket. Appreciate it. It is a peaceful day so far, y'all. I mean, you see the sky. It's been very clear, beautiful. Thank you. Okay, so this should be more than enough to top it off. Once again, have one hand. Okay, so they are good to go. You can see they're in there. They just went from that water to this water over there in the shade. You could probably barely see them, but they're in there around that water right there that's in the shade, and it won't be long before they discover that one. All right, y'all. So Frankie was just over there in the shade by her house, but I got this going for her, and I knew my girl couldn't ignore me. She couldn't ignore me, and she couldn't ignore this. So it's really hot out here today, y'all. So we're getting this going for Frankie. She loves when we do this. So we just spray her down, and this is going to help her out here in this Florida heat today. And we'll do this at least twice a day when it's really hot like this. Y'all see that? Watch, she's gonna roll to her side. Trying to get that stomach wet as well. That's funny. She's having a great time, y'all. Yeah, girl. Mm-hmm. All right, y'all, so the goslings are taken care of. Frankie's taken care of. We also filled up the little kiddie pool for Frankie. Y'all see still on his thing. Jay, hit a dance move for him, man. They like your dance moves, some acapella. You funny, man. So now I'm about to check on the pigs. I have an interesting situation today for the pigs though, y'all. And that is the vet's ass, because Esther's getting a surgery. And if you've ever had surgery before, what does the doctor always ask you? That's right. Do not eat within so many hours before the surgery. So I'm gonna have to figure out how to get the food away from the pigs today. I'm gonna have to figure that out. probably at around dinner time or so, I'm gonna take away, after I know they've gotten some food, take away that feed. No, it's gonna be tricky. You could probably tell, I don't know how I'm gonna do it, but I'm gonna figure it out. Because Esther here will be getting that, we believe it's an umbilical hernia, but we'll get the for sure what it is and solution tomorrow. So I'm about to go ahead and create a wallow right here for them, refill up this pool for them so that they're taken care of as well. Y'all see we have our guy Zeus right here. Zeus, let me show y'all this. So, about to clean out his water, give him fresh water. Y'all know that's going to stay clean for about 2 minutes, but I think I have a solution for that. Not going to be in this video, not sure when I'm going to do it, but I think I have a solution for that. But everyone else is just relaxing, which is cool to see. So, as y'all can see, everyone's over there just relaxing, having a great time, because they had a great breakfast this morning. So, we have Mike, Peanut Butter and Oreo, who were just lying down as well, but they got up because Zeus is over there messing with Mocha, which he loves to do. But y'all see the vegetation, there's so much for them to eat out here, and they've been working on it already, but they're all the way over there in pasture, the rest of them. So yeah, and they were also just lying down as well. Y'all see Spirit right there. They were also just lying down as well, but Zeus just ran them off, so. And y'all, I just noticed this on the fence line. What would y'all say did that? Huh. It looks like it had to be something small, but what are they getting to? So, Achilles doesn't dig. Does Zeus dig? Let me show y'all what I have to fill in at least once a week. This right here. So does Zeus dig? Yes. And as you can see, every time I fill it in, I add another cinder block right at ground level, and then I fill it up, cover it with dirt, and he, like some type of bloodhound, can figure out exactly where there isn't a cinder block yet, and he'll dig around it. So Zeus digs, but you see his holes are significantly bigger than that right there. So I'm gonna get my shovel, I'm gonna fill that in, whatever that was. I mean, it's not messing with those big boys. And you could tell they sleep right here. They've been sleeping right here, y'all. You see that? So, whatever it was, as the boys were right here at some point, tried to come through. Keep an eye on that for sure. All right, y'all. So, hopefully the camera's picking this up, but Zeus, there's no water in there right now. And it's clean. Of course, Zeus just stepped in there. So he just put dirt in there. So I'm gonna go ahead and fill this for Zeus and the girls. If you're like me, the sound of water can be very relaxing. So instead of playing music right here like I normally would and, you know, all that, I'll put you in the time lapse, but listen to this water. And that right there is exactly why I'm building a new feeder. This feeder is perfect for the boys, y'all. You know, it's perfect for the boys. I just have to repair those grates. I'm just putting new cattle panel on them. Shore it up, it'll be good to go, but it's too big for the girls because, I mean, it's smart, it's shade, but I'm gonna do a fence line feeder. And it's nothing fancy. Is y'all know me, I love building things. And as much as I would love to do something very fancy, I think all I'm going to do is like a 2x6 from there, maybe all the way to there, which should be about 16 to 18 feet. And I'm just going to get those same Tractor Supply feeding troughs. And I'm going to just however many a fit all the way down, which I think should be like 6 of them. I'm just going to put them there. I'm going to drill holes in the bottom of it. So if it ever rains and there's food in there, it doesn't get all dirty and nasty and stuff, the water could drain through. And then when we feed them, we'll have this whole section. And in theory, we won't even have to walk in there because you see I'm at the fence now. I'll be able to reach over and imagine they're already right here, right? I'm going to be able to reach over with the scoop or even Egypt and just pour down the line, pour down the line, pour down the line. And it's long enough that every goat should be able to get a place at the table for supper or breakfast, whatever time of day it is, depending on the time of year. And they'll all be able to just get food equally, you know. Now, of course, they're going to play, you know, merry-go-round. So one might start down here, then it'll run down there, and that one will run down there, that one will run down there. But everyone will be able to, you know, do their thing. Woo! Who would have thunk that my way out of this hot Florida sun was to come kick it with Elvis and Priscilla. But here I am, y'all, just checking on their food. And y'all, for one, let me tell y'all something. Yes, I have a fly catcher there, but ever since I built this thing, the flies like overnight left. I don't know why or what impact this thing had on it, because it's a fly. Not only could they still, in theory, fly under here and go down, but they could fly under this and just go down into the food. But for whatever reason, this thing's done the trick. And not only that, you remember I filled it up 1/3 of the way. Look at that. It's almost all gone, y'all. And it's dry. Woo. It works, y'all. It works. Their water right here is still good. You just see down there is dirty from, you know, them pecking around or maybe even scratching, getting some dirt in it. Even though it is off the ground with a pretty thick cinder block. So I'm going to just clean that out real quick. I'm going to refill their food 1/3 of the way. I'm going to go into this other part of Graceland, which this is my favorite part. When they get on that roost right there, y'all, it swings just like that. Man, it's so great. Still thinking we're going to come in here and put like a bench against this wall right here. So if I'm in here like I am right now, I have a place to sit. We have a place to sit and just watch them do their thing. But as you can see through this little door right here, if you're new here, the way they get from this main aviary area to the original Graceland is there's an opening right here and they just cross through. And the way they get from the original Graceland to that, to the fourth bedroom, you know what I mean? That's the, I always make the joke that Graceland is a 4-bed, 3-bath. So to get over there, there's another little entrance. So maybe I could catch it on camera that I'm going back and forth between the door. Here, let me back up over here. Oh, look, look, look. Bam. And Elvis just walked into the main aviary. Y'all see that? And Priscilla just went from the smaller one through that same door, a similar door, into the original Graceland. Water has been cleaned. You can see it's refilling now. About to get their food. And then get to the festivities, y'all. So hopefully you've enjoyed an update on Caramel, an update on Esther. You've got to see the peacocks. You got to see the goats. You got to see Frankie. You got to see the goslings. But hey, I gotta fire this grill up, y'all. Gotta fire this grill up. I love how comfortable they are around us now. And let me throw in some footage of how we celebrated 4th for the rest of this day. I hope everyone out there had a blessed 4th of July, this very special holiday for the United States of America. Hopefully you have some great food and you're surrounded by friends and family. And if not, hopefully technology was able to bring you closer to family. Maybe you did a Zoom call with family. Maybe you did a FaceTime or at least a phone call. For too long, I don't know what else to do. I wanna get away from every little thing just to try to make it through. I've been thinking about my options. Alright, y'all. Telling my have the peacock's food. Let's get it to him. But it doesn't really matter, nothing matters, so I cry instead. All right, y'all, I'm getting a lesson. I have ribs on, have some drumsticks on.
Oh, you can't see.
Yeah. We're getting it going, y'all. Want to be in a video? You sure? Here come the camera. Yeah. All right, y'all, he's still being shy, which is okay. You know, not everyone wants to be on camera. It's not for everybody. But what I will say is I'm out here, and let me rotate this way. We got Jaredith, my brother-in-law. We both getting a master class today. He be on the grill. I'm learning.
Wasting my money, y'all. Wasting my money.
So he's giving us like a master class, and I'm taking notes, y'all. So we got it going. I've been running circles, trying to catch
catch my breath. I've been trying everything I can, but I ain't got nothing left.
Alright y'all, so I'm gonna show y'all a spread at the end. But Mama's in there throwing down on sides inside the house. We've already pulled the ribs. We got them warming or staying warm in the house. So let me show you what's on this pit here. Alrighty. So once again, the ribs are already off, but we have some legs going. We have some breasts and tenders going. And of course there's gonna be other things, but once again, I think I'm gonna just show y'all the finished product, the spread, but we're out here, still going. Still continuing on my journey to pit master, so I'm on pit duties today, y'all.